apparently I'm second generation black Caribbean and half white Scottish, whatever that means. See, lately I feel confused with the boxes, cause to me all they do is breed conflict. It's not that I've lost touch with reality of racism, sexism and nationality, just to me all seems like insanity. Why must I rob you of your humanity to feel good about mine? It's all about crime, dehumanizing's how I justify them, so I must keep lying about the history of Africa so I can live with the massacres and repeat my mantra, Muslim terrorists, so I can sleep at night as bombs take flight. Eyes open wide but I'm blind to the sight, too busy chasing the perfect life, and the working class keep them uneducated. Truly educated men can never be a racist. Educate is to draw out what is within. Are we not all the same under the skin? I got a heart like yours that pumps blood and oxygen, and insecurities, a whole lot of them. I'm scared like you deep down. I really do care that the world's not fair like you, but I don't even believe my own prayers like you. Chasing career, going nowhere like you. Lost in a fog of my own insecurity, I hold myself up as an image of purity, and I judge everybody else by the color of the skin or the size of their wealth. But it's not good for my health, as the only one I ever really judge is myself. The oppressor must suffer like the oppressed, though I pretend I'm in control of this mess by inflating my ego, puffing my chest. See our weakness and our need to show strength for what we think strong is, cause if we're honest, true strength is the strength to be honest. And if I'm honest, I am just tired. If I'm honest, I am just tired. Tired of every day filling up my car and knowing that I'm paying for the bombs in Iraq. Tired of pretending it don't hurt my heart, of wanting change, not knowing where to start. Tired of listening to all the conditioning and all the forms that they got me filling. And next time you see what you think is a thug and despise him, please know I was just like him, cause I was like 8 first time I saw crack. Same time I first smoked weed, choking on blowbacks. First time I saw knives penetrate flesh, it was meat cleavers to the back of the head. As I grew and teenage years passed, many more knives pierced and the shots blast. And I ain't saying I had the worst upbringing, but there's a million young men just like me in prison. We complain about racism, elevate clowns with their trousers down, swinging their dick round. Maybe that is not quite literal, but everything they do is just a stereotypical. To my real fans, I feel your pain, and I get the messages, but don't complain that we ain't got more fame. We're playing a part. They can keep the charts, all I want is your hearts. They can keep the charts, all I want is your hearts. They can keep the charts, all I want is your hearts. Call it black radio, don't make me laugh. So is black music all about tits and ass? You don't represent nothing, you're just pretending. When was the last time you ever played Hendrix or Miles Davis or John Coltrane or Ella Fitzgerald or Billie Holiday? We can call it urban, to me that's cool. If urban means street, that includes jazz too, and rock for that matter. Go ask Mick Jagger or Jimmy Page what they were listening to. The blues, not discrediting Love Zeppelin too, just giving credit where credit is due. That blog soap word rappers still use, all it really shows is we still self-abuse. That was the word that was used to kill Kelso, Coltrane and Emmett Till. That was the word that the conscience eased and made people pleased to hung you from trees. That was the word that let the whips crack. No matter what you say, you can't take it back. And I could say they're black, so I feel their pain easier. But 1915, look at Armenia. It's the whole world, this human stupidity that we choke ourselves to death, quite literally. And I can talk with my comfortable mouth and my comfortable clothes in my comfortable house. The tables will turn, we can but stall them. Every empire on this earth has fallen. So unless we can find another way, maybe not today, but it'll come one day. And it may sound like I'm bitter, but in fact, truth be told, I am quite the opposite. I wake every day and I'm overwhelmed just to be alive and be like no one else. And the sheer weight of the thought of space is enough to keep my little ego in place. All that we chase and try to replace, all along it was right in our face. The only way we can ever change anything's to look in the mirror and to find no enemy. The only way we can ever change anything, look in the mirror and to find no enemy.